just start off by saying congratulations, first off, on not only the film, but being a part of South by Southwest. That's huge for you guys. What has this been like, both filming it and now getting to do these press junkets and talk more about it, but also celebrate it?
Yeah, it's been like kind of you can't there's been no time for reflection in a way that's like really cool, where it's just like, okay, like you just have to really just be like in it each step of the way. And you know, Duran and I especially have like the longest to-do lists of stuff, so there's like always, you know, things that need to be worked on, but it's all like really, really exciting. You know, at first it felt quite surreal, like when I had received the email about getting into South by Southwest. It was like midnight. I just saw it, and I actually, to be honest, I just assumed it was a rejection, right? So I just like I clicked it, and I did not see the smiley face in the subject line. So I just like I clicked it, and I was like, all right. And I'm reading, and I'm like, oh shit, oh shit. And my wife's brushing her teeth. I'm like, oh shit. And then she's like, oh shit. And so then, you know, and then I try to call everyone, but everyone's asleep. I was like, no, except our 24-year-old cinematographer who was awake. And so she was awake,
Wait, but the
and.
best part of that is that she had just finished watching May December.
Love
So
that.
it was such a vibe shift for her.
It was so it was it's been that was funny. And then it's just been, yeah, it's been really, really cool. And I think there's something very like, you know, we've been doing these you know, been in film, all of us, and for a long time in different capacities and in different roles. So I think it just felt like really, really like validating to have someone see what we do. And like I think everything that we've done in the past too has been like really interesting and cool, but like you do need someone to sort of see what it is you're trying to do and get it. And I love that, you know, all South by Southwest saw was the first rough cut. That's what they saw, and it got in off of that first rough cut. And it's like that means they saw it, they understood what was there, they felt the potential of what it could be. And like, you know, like I don't know, it feels like a real blessing. It's been very, very cool. That's
Definitely.
my perspective of it. But
Does
let the
everyone agree with
interchange
that?
go on.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's you know, it's super gratifying for a couple of reasons. One, you know, we've been working together now for about 10 years, and sort of on we've been really blessed to have Sean as sort of like the artistic head of this triumvirate in some ways. And we always believed in his vision and his taste, and it's just, you know, it's so hard to get a feature film made, and so hard to find the right season of your life to do that in. And you know, it was really thrilling that all of the last 10 years of struggle and new drafts and little projects and doubts and questions and breakthroughs all culminated in like this really exciting moment for this film. So I think there's that. And I think also like this year there is like a huge flood of South Asian films that are at the festival. And I think it's just it's exciting to be a part of that as well, to show this other little part of the, what is the diamond, the little another little slice of the diamond. I don't know what I'm saying, but it, you know, another story that adds to the complexity of like South Asian stories is like is really cool. And for Sean to be like the first Sri Lankan director to have a film at the festival is like, I mean, it's history making. So that is thrilling as well.
Yeah.
I think something that's so lovely about the South by aspect of all of this is that, I mean, for me, we've been, the three of us have been working together on with these characters in various capacities for the last 10 years, and it's been such a fruitful collaboration. It's been such like a home base for each other, and it's been incredibly gratifying in so many ways just to have that connection and to be exploring these characters in this project in different ways. So for me, the biggest win was finally making the feature. Like that in and of itself was incredible. And so like such a beautiful culmination of all the work that we had been doing up until then. And so that would have been enough, honestly. Just like us seeing that through and getting to tell that story finally would have been enough for me. And then we got into South By, and how fucking cool. So it just feels like a beautiful way to celebrate something that we've put a lot of ourselves into for so many years.
Yeah. And I love that this is roughly based off of your life, Sean, But as actors and a producer, what was it like taking this project on? And is there a certain amount of change that you make to these characters knowing that it's coming from a true story?
I think for me, and Sadia can speak for himself as well, but for me, it was never about trying to be someone else. It was just kind of meeting the script where it was at, and meeting who I read Suzanne on the page. And then over the years, of course, getting to know Sean better as a human, getting to know his wife, Christine, understanding little bits of their dynamic that crept into the script, understanding bits of Sean that crept into the script, him putting bits of me into the script that I would be like, oh yeah, I do that. We kind of collected pieces of ourselves that also gave us this wonderful shorthand once we actually were able to shoot the feature, because you're looking at the script and I'm like, I know this is a joke because I know Sean's sense of humor and I know his aesthetic. So I know, like, I have this deeper understanding of where all of that's living. And so that was a great gift to have. But in terms of my own work, I always saw Suzanne as herself, I guess. And these were just little bits and influences that crept in.
Yeah, fair
I'm just doing my best Sean impression.
enough.
This is possible. I'm just cosplaying. No, similar to what Anastasia said, like, these characters feel like an amalgamation of, Sean as a 24-year-old, whenever that happened to, whenever the events of this story actually happened to him, Sean as he's aged and grown up, and as he's gotten to know us, parts of our personality that are in there, and then there's also like our own spins on these character and things that are personal to us that we have found inside the characters. So they do feel like a kind of beautiful, exquisite corpse of like a creation, a Frankenstein in some ways, that we have a lot of ownership over, because we've gotten to live in these characters now in this relationship for, three shorts.
And I will say,
Totally.
as a testament to Sean as well, these characters have grown and evolved with us, with all of us. There was never like a prescriptive moment of like, this character must be like this. He really allowed us to be collaborators with that and in that process. And that's been really, really satisfying as well.
Yeah, upon meeting him, I mean, one of the most exciting things about the story, I think, being the, like, there was like the fresh voice in the midst of a journey of 10 years. It's kind of like when you add a free agent to your basketball team and it's like, oh, this was the missing ingredient kind of feeling. One of the things that I think it rewarded was we really got a chance to look at the script. For me, it was always look at the script from the idea that this is Ben and Suzanne, not, Sean and his past. And so, we did a lot of really great work, and it was a testament to his flexibility as a writer and director to be open to the idea that, earlier drafts I'd read and I say to him, I was like, I don't want any audience member to watch this movie and feel like we're commenting on Suzanne or we're commenting on Ben. I really want someone to wrestle with, no, these are two very even experiences in which two very genuine, authentic human beings are both either communicating together or missing communication, never creating a bad guy. And one of the great things I think about Sean was that he was so willing to hear a fresh voice say, that feels a little heavy-handed. And the best part about not knowing him for as long was I got to go, that doesn't feel like the character in your script. That feels like it might be from something else. And whenever he would pivot in those ways, it really, I think, allowed for Ben and Suzanne to truly have their own life, as opposed to feeling like, you've seen those movies before where, I'm not going to name any directors, but you're like, oh, you clearly didn't get over your blank, and now you're, venting about him or her. And what Sean was able to do with this was really allow for the organic nature of two really lovable and likable human beings just wrestling with the complexities of what a modern relationship would actually go through.
Definitely. Sean,
Just
I feel like this is just praise to how great you
it's
are.
all very this is awesome. I mean, like, when
John,
we
do you know what basketball is? Yaron brought up
basketball.
basketball. So it's a sport with a ball and a hoop, just so you know.
It's the one with
We're
the
learning,
stick,
we're
right?
learning.
It's on the stick.
Well, just to sort of speak to, like, the kind of like 10 years of it all, and like the sort of like the characters and like the sort of perspectives of it, like, it is, while it's, some I don't even really want to own the sort of like based on a true story part of it, because like I don't, it's, I'm not interested in like solipsism and just like, it's like, oh, this happened to me and so it needs to be this way. And so like, I think because of like this journey that we've like taken together and like how these characters have sort of changed in form and different like perspectives, like, you know, offering like ideas and thoughts, it's like, it really becomes its own thing. And like, these truly are just like, it's not like me and my past, it's anymore. And like maybe draft one and two very much, yeah. But like, you know, drafts like three through like a billion, no. And it's it really much is like, no, it's like these are Ben and Suzanne in whatever way we are all kind of like discovering who Ben and Suzanne are, not like who these characters need to be. We were never trying to aim for like a target of what it's supposed to be.
Definitely. And a part that I caught on to was the reference to their movie Starship Troopers. Ultimately, it brings Ben and Suzanne together and closer. I'm wondering for you guys, is there a movie in your life that's connected you to others in your life?
Oh my God.
Well, Sean and his wife, Christine, and I watch a movie together every New Year's for the last couple of years now. So that's not so much a specific movie, but that's been a really nice tradition that we've had.
I love that.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then we fight about it.
Fight about it. There it is.
Yeah, for me, it's like, I don't know. It's like movies are such like, it's part of like literally everything I do. Like, you know, my day job, I'm in school right now. I'm a teacher and like I teach film and like my students are in the other room. They're watching Celine Sciamma's Girlhood today, right? So now after they watch this movie, we're going to have a relationship based on that movie. You know, Seth and I had gone to see the Apu trilogy in theaters together, you know, and like when it was re-released after it had been restored. Duran and I still haven't had a chance to have our movie date yet, but we were making plans to go see Godzilla Minus One, and we talk about movies a lot. So like in Anastasia, like we're always like watching movies, and Anastasia is also so good about like, hey, you should like check this out, and then she'll like text me about it, and then we're like having these conversations. So like, I don't know, it's like movies are everything, and sort of like how it's definitely one of the filters of which I am able to sort of like find a lot of connections and like community with people. So yeah, there's not any one particular movie. It's like movies, period. Like movies as a concept and as an idea, as like a powerful communicator.
I will say also that that was a big part of my preparation for Suzanne over the, has been a big part of my preparation for Suzanne over the years. Sean, I think, has great taste in film for the most part. And he's sent me a lot of reference films for either a specific character that feels in the world of Suzanne or some scenes that feel in the world of Suzanne. And I love homework, so I'll watch them all. And so that's been real. And he's inspired by a very diverse handful of movies for this particular feature. And so that's been a fun part of kind of getting into the world of this character.
Definitely. And I am getting wrapped, but my last question for you, if you guys could describe this film in three words, what would they be?
Ben and Suzanne?
That's three words. Sincere, horny, honest.
Okay. I see Doran still thinking.
I'm a wordsmith, so I'm always intentional. I would say I do mean this. It's a future of cinema. Independent storytelling from a faith forward standpoint is the future of cinema.
I love that.
I'm not gonna beat that. It's beautiful.
Yes. Well, congratulations on everything again. And thank you so much for your time.
Thank you so much.